Shavua tov, everyone. Agudvach. We're going to start right now. Thank you for being with us. Kechu imachem, imachem devori, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. Kechu imachem, imachem devorim, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. Kechu imachem, imachem devorim, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. Kechu imachem, imachem devorim, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. La 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 la. Bum bum me, da da da, I na na da di di, I na di 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 di, I na di 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 di, da 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 da, I na da da di da ro ro, I na di da I na da da da. Kechu imachem, imachem devarim, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. Kechu imachem, imachem devarim, shuvu v'shuvu el Hashem. Eliyahu hanavi, Eliyahu atishbi, ein yohadi nabi. Eliyahu hanavi, Eliyahu atishbi, Eliyahu adi nabi. Eliyahu hanavi, Eliyahu atishbi, ein yohadi nabi. Eliyahu hanavi, Eliyahu
I don't know.
So I want to sing a Matzah Shabbos Nigun that we try to sing in our house, don't always succeed to, but when we do, it's very, very special. And I've sung it many times in my father's house. And it's all the brachas in the world that I would wish for any week. But I think more than ever, I would wish it on this week, a week of brachas. So I know that right now, there's so much in the air and there's so many different emotions, but it's a Shavua Tov. It's the beginning of a week. So let's put brachas into the air. Let's put brachas out there, especially these words.
Levacha, shlachtish mi lenenacha, menas yadayin v'anacha. Ya'asa lechotzuri, lekabetzam, lefuzari, miyadai, achzari, asher kara li shulcha. It's doini to oiner er the maletama shereshoyer. It's tucha bevoi goyer v'sebezurani bacha. It's tucha bevoi goyer v'sebezurani bacha. Be'ula ve'ema bani smecha ma'ayonais azay zuvu uftuye adoinai oide shuvu ve'yeshai shavu ve'hatzada anishkacha from the waters of salvation all troubles will be forgotten. Neche amcha ke'avrachama yitzav tefu'am lo aman dvar adonai asher ne'eman ma'akim chavtacha. Vidim pletei chenet beginasa yiftachu v'meret li tzevacha uvli feret ein yoytzez ve'ein tzvacha yehi hachoydesh ha'azeh kinivu asra v'choyzeh Veishama bebayit zeh kol sosoi bekol simcha. Veishama bebayit zeh kol sosoi bekol simcha. Chazakim alem yishaloi seinu amitz yaseh bakashoi seinu vehu yishlach Masi yadeinu v'racha v'atzlacha. Ay b'maytzay yovayim gila shimcha naida alida shlachtish li l'am segula levach sasan v'hanacha kol tzahala Melina Svasemo az Teda nehenah Anadoi nai hoi shiana Anadoi nai atzlichana Ladai dai dai lidei oi eroi Noe doro do Ai dai doi doi do Ana Hashem Hishiana, Ana Hashem Atzmichana, Ana Hashem Aneinu Beyom Koreinu. Shavua Tom Barach, everyone. We'll sing a little bit more, a little bit later. You all look amazing. You all look very, very, very shiny and ready for a Yom Kippur that obviously no one could have ever dreamed of. But very much a Yom Kippur that is very much exactly the type that we need right now. I first of all want to give a big, big, big yisher koyach to all the beautiful chevra that have continued to learn despite the fact that things have been difficult. To all the people that are still not giving up. And that's a big thing. It's not a pashut thing. It's not a simple thing at all. I also want to give a yisher koyach to all the doctors in our neighborhood. All the anshei, all the people that are involved in any tzorech tzibur, in any tzorech tzibur, be'emunah HaKadosh Baruch Hu yishalem tzcharchem. And I also want to wish an immediate refuah shlema to everyone, those that are nearby and those that are further away. Everyone should be gebench with just a chatima tova, that the chatima should be a good one, it should be a sweet one. When we go into the sukkah, when we leave the sukkah, we say a very interesting thing. And I think about it already on Yom Kippur, even though it's something that shows up in one of the tefillahs that we say when we leave the sukkah. And we say, "V'teitiv lanu achatima." Teitiv lanu achatima. That means that the way that you inscribed me, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the book that you inscribed me in, and the manner in which my life is destined to play out this coming year. So I have to believe that it's good, right? But v'teitiv lanu achatima, that I shouldn't just have to believe that it's good, I should also feel that it's good. Maybe that's what it means when we say, batov hanire v'hanigle, that we should be inscribed with goodness that can actually be seen. Goodness that can be seen, goodness that can be revealed. Because quite often, and especially this year, and this past year, we've had to implement emuna over and over again to connect with the tov that we believe. But I want to see it, the titiv lano chatima, it should sit good with me. It should feel good with me. So last week, it's very interesting how you can do these things today, and get a lot of answers that you never thought you'd get, but and get them pretty fast. I posted on social media the following question. I posted the question, something, I don't remember the exact lashon, maybe I'll look at it really fast. That's a very interesting thing that we can do this year in Shabbos Shuva Drasha, as opposed to being in shul. I had posted this year, just a few days ago, the following question. Here it is. What are some of the questions you would really like the answers to this year? So other than an answer regarding Harry Potter, and then another question was who killed JFK, most of the answers were very much shilas of like, you know, what's going on deep down in the kishkas. No, they really were. Some of the, you know, a lot of the answers were answers of ad masai, you know, till when, or when, you know, this question of time. Time was a very big thing in the answers that we got because we're so having to change our concept of time. So many of the questions, and they were great questions, were really ones of you know, ad matai abba, ad matai, till when will I know? Do I have a chance? How close am I? How far am I? These are all very, very beautiful. They're very beautiful answers to my question. And these were answers that actually began larger threads, longer threads, which led to many beautiful discussions. So, Chevra, we Baruch Hashem, we're going to jump right into the heart of what we're talking about tonight. Yom Kippur, the Torah says, you know, the Rosh Hashanah is all remazim in the Torah. Rosh Hashanah is all remez. It's not really clear, Yom HaZikaron, Yom Teruah, but it's not as clear as Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is clear. There's no questions. And when it comes to Yom Kippur, the Torah doesn't just tell us, about Shvitat Melacha, about things that you can't do. But there's a very interesting way in which the Torah explains what we're not allowed to do. It explains it in a very interesting way. And that pasuk is, Ve'initem et nafshotechem. That the Torah tells us that you shall, well, we're going to hopefully explain this in a second. Ve'initem et nafshotechem, you shall afflict your nefesh. You shall afflict your nefesh. And the way we understand afflicting the nefesh, afflicting the soul, the lowest part of the soul, remember, nefesh, ruach, neshama, chaya yechida, so this lowest part of the soul, there's this concept of nefesh. Ve'initem et nafshotechem, you're going to afflict the soul. But let me ask you, Chavra. And those of us that have had Yom Kippur together, and those of us that Be'ezer Hashem will have many Yom Kippurs together, does your soul feel afflicted when you're in Yom Kippur? I'm getting the goosebumps thinking about just last year's Yom Kippur. My chevr all around me. And yes, no fat, no eating, no drinking, a certain level of affliction. It would make more sense if it said, ve'initem et gufchem, that you afflict your body. But ve'initem et nafshotechem, could be this year, it might be like that, I don't know. But in years where the clock, mizman, stops being of any essence, doesn't play any role, and the Yom Kippur rhythm is on. If you try to go back, do you remember feeling like your soul is being afflicted? Lahefech hagamur, completely on the contrary. There's no inui of the nefesh. There's absolutely simchas nefesh. There's prichata, in a good way, prichata nefesh, the blossoming of the nefesh, simchata nefesh, shuvata nefesh. The nefesh feels like it's doing shuva. It's exactly the opposite of an inui. I know it's weird to look forward to Yom Kippur, but I mean, it actually, you know, this year, again, we're going to explain in a second how this year it's a little bit different. But, and everyone that needs help with fasting should have an easy and peaceful fast. But if fasting is not so much of an issue for you, being in shul in a sea of tefillah, with that ruach that's up there, that's bouncing off the walls, that's not an inui. That's not a torture. That's not affliction. That's an unbelievable moment of oneness, which is what Yom Kippur is all about. Yechida. Many years ago, I saw in Slonim, and I don't remember right now which sefer it was, when the chaver will tell me. Perhaps it was Nesiva Shalom, maybe one of the previous ones, Birkas Avram, Beis Avram. That the Shlomo Rebbe says, don't say ve'initem, ela ve'anitem. Don't spell out the pasuk to say you torture your soul. Say ve'anitem, that you answer your soul. Ve'anitem, natatem tshuva. Ani rotze la'anot, I want to answer. You answer your nefesh. And Yom Kippur. The question is, what's the question of the nefesh? What is the soul asking? Mitachat lakol, underneath everything. What is the soul asking? Now, of course, all those questions we said before, ad matai, v'chule, as much as we'd like to believe that that's the nefesh asking, it'll be shocking, but it's actually the body more than the nefesh. The body's state of galut, the concealment that the body feels, is asking ad masai. The nefesh is asking ad masai from the moment that it comes down into this world. But the body is asking ad matai, ad matai, ad matai. That's not so much the nefesh that we're speaking about. The nefesh has a question that gets answered on Yom Kippur. And that question is very, very, very simple question. And that question is, am I for real? Am I for real? And somehow on Yom Kippur, through this day that was designated before the world was even created, Yomim Yutzaru Velo Echad Behem, this day on Yom Kippur, the Yetzer Hara, which usually has a complete hold on answering that question, am I for real? On Yom Kippur, something changes and the Yetzer Hara does not have a hold onto that question. We ask that Shaiva without even knowing it, and we get an answer as well. Am I for real? Am I for real? Am I be'emet? Do I really want good? Or am I told that I should want good? But am I really, really wanting good? Am I a person that I could say about myself with utmost humility, I want people to have a good life. I want my surroundings to be having a better world to live in. Am I from those that are for real? I could look at him and I could look at her and I could say they're for real. That's easy. But to say, am I for real? The Yetzer Hara somehow usually tells us, you're probably not. But on Yom Kippur, because of Yom Kippur, because of something that happens on Yom Kippur, which we're going to figure out tonight, something changes to that answer. And the answer is, well, let's see. I'm not going to give it to you right away. It's not just a simple yes. But let's understand how we do that. Let's develop this question a little bit deeper. Usually, when I say the question, am I for real, when I think of it from a very deep place, how would I answer that when it's not my nefesh talking? How does my goof answer that question? So very simple. Am I for real? Did you do all the things that you want to do? Did you fulfill all the things you took on? When was the last time you didn't stumble again upon something that you weren't supposed to stumble upon? And I answer the question like that. And in the name of being real, I say, well, I'm not so real. Hopefully next year, I'll be from those people that want it for real. And I can answer it. But the Rambam is going to show us something. We're going to learn the Rambam very differently right now. The Rambam shows us a very important yesod when it comes to the world of tshuva, which will explain to us a manner in which we can answer this question, am I for real? So you'll see right now the first source for tonight. This is a classic piece of Rambam and Hilchos Tshuva. I also want to thank my dear, dear Chaver Shimon Detweiler again for running the Zoom tonight so beautifully. Thank you, Shimon. You and the family should be blessed with many good years and only good news, Bezrat Hashem. So the Rambam says like this in Hilchos Tshuva, Perek Gimel, Halacha Chet. Lefichach. צריך כל אדם שיראה עצמו כל השנה כולה, כאילו חציו זכאי וחציו חייב. All year long, a person must see himself to be someone who is like on a scale of good or bad, 50-50. But not just to see himself as being on that scale that's kind of like even. וכן כל העולם, חציו זכאי וחציו חייב. The whole world as well. That half the world, if the world was put on a scale and the world was standing before judgment and the world is saying, do I deserve another year? So the way that we have to visualize it, the Rambam says, is that you have to see the world itself being on shpilkas, chata chet echad, if a person sinned one sin, hare hichriya atzmo v'hichriya et kol ha'olam kulo lekaf chova. When you go down, you take everyone down yourself. V'garam lahem hashchata. The Rambam says, obviously, no pressure, but you are taking the whole world down with you when you tilt that scale. If you're on a 50-50, and you go to the left, and the left is the place where it's the no-good place, you cause the whole world to go down. Asa mitzvah achat, if a person did one mitzvah, hare hichriya atzmo v'hichriya et kol ha'olam kulo lekav zchut. Person does one mitzvah, then he really does take the whole world to the place of zchut v'garan lahem tshu'a v'hatzala. And he caused the whole world tshu'a v'hatzala, meaning you bring redemption to the whole world. Okay, we can come out of over here, come out of the text. Now let me ask you, friends, quite frankly, quite honestly, which one is it easier to believe in? Is it easier to believe that when we do something bad, we take the whole world down? Or is it easier to believe that when we do something good, we raise the whole world up with us? So you don't have to answer that question, but I'm going to say it again, and I want you to think about it as we continue learning. Let's just be emet l'amito. What is easier to believe? What is easier to identify with? That when I do one avera, I drag myself and everyone else down? Or that when I do a mitzvah, I pull everyone else up, myself included. What is easier for me to connect to? What do I usually feel is more the emet? What's more the emet? So to continue to help us understand how this works, I want to learn with you one paragraph from Rabbi Nachman. This paragraph, this is the middle of a long Torah, Torah Ayin Tet and Likutei Maharan. This teaching is just much more simple than we think, I think, and yet so much deeper at the same moment, if that makes any sense. But this is from Likutei Maharan, Torah Ayin Tet. Rabbi Nachman is going to address the obvious question, which is, what is tshuva? And how does someone do tshuva? So, before we read the text, I want to remind us all of a famous statement of Chazal, which is a very, very important statement. And I'm sure you've heard this statement before, but it's very important the night before Yom Kippur to remember this. It's very important every day of the year, but the night before Yom Kippur, it's mamash important. The Chazal tell us, "Ein HaKadosh Baruch Hu ba bitrunia im briyotav," which means that whatever your concept is of God, our belief is the following. Hashem Yitbarach does not want anything more than what someone is capable of doing. En HaKadosh Baruch Hu ba bitrunia im briyotav. It's a very, you know, I think what I'm going to do, now that I'm saying it, it's just, this happens quite often. Teachers could identify with this, that when you teach something that you think you knew, but when you give it over and you really start to feel like you connect to it more, you feel like you want to stop everything and just give a shiur on this moment of understanding. But I just want to share with you my feeling is what I want to do is I want to print out this statement from Chazal, En HaKadosh Baruch Hu ba bitrunia im briyotav, and I want to put it on my shtender to have in front of me on Yom Kippur. Because this statement is key to understand what the Rambam was saying, and it's key to understand the tshuva of the nefesh, the answer of the soul. Again, Hashem Yitbarach, I know it's hard to believe this, because it seems, especially today, that there are things and tests that we're going through that are impossible for us to really do. God doesn't want anything more than what someone is capable of doing. Meaning, the point is, don't faint from hard work. Don't work until you get pneumonia. Don't work until you get a headache, because that's how you're yotze. You must do what you can. You just have to discover what you can do. Okay, that's a whole other thing. Do what you can. Discover what you can do and do it. More than that, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, En HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ba Bitrunia Im Briyotav. I remember when I was in yeshiva here in Hamiftar, there was a guy that showed up one summer, and he was a really eccentric guy, very far out, a genius, mamash atamid chacham. He leaned in a very unique way, where he was able to do both the Ashkenazis and Taimani simultaneously. It sounded something like Vayedaber Hashem El Maisha Lemaid, something like that. It was crazy. Mamish everything. Very eccentric fellow. So I said to him, Tisha B'Av was coming up. I said to him, what was Tisha B'Av like, you know, when you were growing up? He said, well, at a certain point, I took on, you know, the obvious minhag of I would stay up all night long and I would go through all my t-shirts and tear them, rip them, crying in tears to the Ribono Shleilam until I didn't have any tears left inside. I said to him, do you think that's what you have to do? He's like, that's what every yid should be doing. I'm hoping no one else heard that conversation because I don't know anyone else that ever experienced Tisha B'Av like that before. But Ein HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ba'Bitruni Am Briyotav is a statement that needs to be internalized. That the Ribono Shel Olam does not expect you to, for lack of better term, kill yourself in order to get a job done. That's not necessarily what Mesiras Nefesh means. For many people, Mesiras Nefesh right now is not going to shul, not going to a minyan. That's their Mesiras. It's not going to a minyan. It's not going. It's an unbelievable thing. The terminology of Mesiras Nefesh is one that needs to be replayed and re-understood. But let's say like this, I want to do things right. And I believe that Hashem does not expect of me things that I'm not capable of doing. So the question is, this the most simple question, how do I do tshuva? If I want to change, how could I do tshuva? Can I say that everything will be different from now? Can I apologize to myself this Erev Yom Kippur and say, Shlomo, I am so sorry that I let you down from accomplishing all the things that you dreamed of doing that you didn't get a chance to? So how do I do that? Again, Ein HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ba'Bitruni Am Briyotav. So Rabbi Nachman is going to explain to us so beautifully the difference between the Yetzer Hara's version of tshuva and the Emes version of tshuva. Ki yesh shnei tshuvot. Achat, yesh bnei adam she'osin masa umatan veholchin behavlei ha'olam hazeh. There are two types of tshuva. The first type of tshuva are people, they're busy in this world. Veholchin behavlei olam hazeh. They have to go through the vanity of this world. They have to go through the olam hazeh stuff. Ube'emtza'ut nofelo hirhurei tshuva. And while he's going through what he's going through, they have moments of wanting to do tshuva. Ve'achar kach chozer limkomo arishon. But that moment of either wanting to do tshuva or actually doing tshuva doesn't last. It existed, both in a thought and perhaps in an action as well, but it doesn't exist. Rabbi Nachman says, then it goes back to its first place. Like it says in Yecheskel, v'hachayot ratzov v'shov, the animals, this is the whole story of the Ma'aseh Merkava, back and forth, back and forth. This explains our lives. She'ein lo naicha. We don't have any calm inside. Why? Pam tameh, pam tahor, pam kasher, pam pasul, asur. Umutar. Rabbi Nachman says, this is a situation that most of us are very well acquainted with. What situation is that? Is that we just don't consider what Rabbi Nachman just considered to be tshuva to actually tshuva. Rabbi Nachman says, the type of tshuva we're saying is that, well, once One day I'm tame, one day I'm tahor, one day I'm pure, one day I'm impure. One day I'm feeling it, and I'm doing holy things, one day I'm not feeling it. One day I succeed for half a minute to not let jealousy take over me, and then I'm jealous of friends and neighbors another 20 times till Shabbos. One day I caught myself with my anger, and I stopped being angry over something. And I say to myself, man, maybe I really chapped this whole inyan of kaas. And then I continue getting angry for the next 3 months. One day I wake up and I say, today I'm going to learn. I'm going to start a chavrusa. And I start learning. I open up the Mesilas Yisharim. I take a Mishnah. I learn a Mishnah. I learn, open up a Tanakh. I'm starting Yeshua. I'm starting from the beginning of Nevi'im. Or I'm starting Tehillim. And I start saying Tehillim. I start saying a few moments of Tehillim. And what's so amazing is that, again, that happens for 5 minutes. But I don't end up opening a Sefer again for 5 months. Pa'am ken, pa'am lo. Pa'am ken, pa'am lo. This is a situation we are all very much acquainted with. We know what this is all about. But what is this story all about? What situation is this all about? So Rabbi Nachman says that you have to understand this was called tshuva. This is the first level of tshuva. It's a level. Nachon, it's not shalem. It's true. It's not complete. But it's tshuva. You know why it's tshuva? Because, you know, the Zohar HaKadosh says, who is someone that's considered a winner? Not someone who conquered his enemies, but the Zohar says, one who's holding their weapon on the battlefield. That's a winner. That's a winner. Remember the question we started with, am I for real? Usually the way the Yetzer Hara wants us to answer that question is not defining a winner based on the Zohar HaKadosh. The Zohar HaKadosh says, who's a winner? One who has been able to bury all his enemies. That's a winner. Sorry, that's the Yetzer Hara. That's what he says. The Zohar HaKadosh says it's not true. You're on the battlefield. The ammunition's in your arm. And you hit a target and you missed a few and you stopped even using it, but it's still in your hand. Rabbi Nachman says this is tshuva number one and you're a winner. Why? You're fighting. You're working. And even if you keep on failing, what does this prove to you? It proves that you actually want to change. You want to be different. It's not a simcha. You know those times, those moments, you're fighting over your holiness. You're fighting over your Torah. Even if they're rare, especially when it comes to Hirhurim, Raim, Shmiras Habris, you say, I conquered this. And then you say you don't conquer it. So what are you? You're a Nebuch? No, you're a warrior that keeps on working. You keep on working. This is a type of tshuva. You're in the story. You're in the right story. These moments prove to you that this is what you really want in life. That's what these moments prove to you. That you are for real. The problem is, we're under the impression, and Rabbi Nachman says, this is called Zel Bechinas Sheshes Yemei HaChol. This tshuva is called the 6 days of the week. It's the, why? Because during the week there's no naicha. Pam ken, pam lo. I'm feeling it, I'm not feeling it. I'm busy in this world, I'm busy in the next world. I have a moment of being up there, a moment of being down here. That's called the tshuva of the 6 days of the week. Rabbi Nachman is saying, do not belittle this tshuva. But you have to wait till Yom Kippur to acknowledge this tshuva is actually real. You know, this type of tshuva when there's no rest, you know, it's an amazing thing. You know why Rabbi Nachman says an amazing thing? Why is it that when we do this type of tshuva, pam ken, pam lo, we really bring a korban? Because what are we craving? What are we bringing a korban of? We're bringing a korban called menucha. We're sacrificing our menucha in this world. Wouldn't it be much more simple if I lived like the dude? You know who the dude is, right? Can't believe I'm blanking right now on his name, but I actually can't believe it because I haven't seen this movie in many, many years. The Big Lebowski. The dude. Weekday. Does anything bother him? Menucha. He's not aware that there's something bigger. Nothing's bothering him. He's not letting anything say to him, you know, I gotta get my act together. I gotta do things better. Shtuyot. Nothing. You see, if you don't recognize that there's any work to be done, you're in a state of menucha. But a yid in this world that chooses to wake up for one moment, he's in a place of hakrava, of you sacrifice your menucha, you sacrifice your rest, you sacrifice your peace. You bring a korban to Hashem, and it's called my menucha, my rest. And sometimes the Yitzhara says, yeah, you know, if only I would lie to myself, I'd be quiet and fine. But we realize that as life is getting more and more closer to a world of Yom Shekulo Shabbos, this type of tshuva is the last few moments of us being able to be immersed in the tshuva of the 6 days of the week. Now, what's Yom Kippur called? Yom Kippur is called Shabbat Shabbaton. Yom Kippur is called the Shabbos of all Shabboses. So Rabbi Nachman says, "Aval tshuva shleima hu bechinat Shabbat." Complete tshuva. This is the next paragraph. Complete tshuva is the aspect of Shabbos. Sheyesh lo naicha ki ba Shabbat ba menucha. Sheyesh lo menucha mikol vakol venitcha hara legamri. The world of tshuva that we say is like Shabbos is not pam ken, pam lo. It's not today I'm feeling very holy, tomorrow I don't. It's not I open up a sefer today, I don't open it up again for 3 weeks. It's that I open up all the svarim and I keep on learning them. It's that I stop doing something and I never ever do it again. That's the bechina of Shabbos, of the tshuva of Shabbos. And we know that the second level of tshuva, we don't really understand what it is. But when we say, Harachaman hu yanchileinu leyom shekulo Shabbos, means, Ribon Hashem, one day, I'm going to wake up in the morning, decide to serve you, and live through that all day long. I won't have to restart. I won't have to reboot the program. I'll just be able to keep on going nonstop after that first decision to come and be close to you. But while we're here in this world, this concept of Pam Ken, Pam Lo, the tshuva of Pam Tahor, Pam Tameh, Pam Kasher, Pam Pasul, this is still the Bechinas of the Sheshes Yemei Chol. And the Yetzer Hara does not allow me to feel any type of value towards that type of tshuva. The Yetzer Hara says, if you're living in a Pam Ken, Pam Lo world, face it, face it. You're just setting yourself up for failure. So all year long, when I try to understand the tshuva of Sheshes Yemei Chol, and I try to see, hey, is it working for me? Am I for real? The Yetzer Hara comes and tells you, absolutely not. Come on. You know what real's like. Real's like on Yom Kippur, right? Real's like on Yom Kippur when you're like an angel and you're dancing in shul and everything is flying so high. Remember what it felt like on Yom Kippur? And every year we could go back and say, remember what it felt like on Yom Kippur? And this year, we're not going to be able to say for the rest of the year, remember what it felt like on Yom Kippur? When? When I had to wake up really early, daven really fast, get out of the sun, be outside with 20 people, go back home, come back quickly for Mincha Ne'ila. This year, this game of am I for real is being taken to the next level. Because all year long, I say to myself, you know, one day a year, I'm for real. That day that I'm swimming and davening and nothing exists other than me and the Ribono Shel Olam. And all year long, when I say, am I for real? I compare myself to Yom Kippur and I usually say, I'm not so real. And Yom Kippur, that's how you have to be all year long. But what a chesed is done for us this year. You see, chevra, this year, this concept of feeling Yom Kippur is going to be very different than whatever it was till now. But I believe that it's because the Ribbono Shel Olam is enabling us that so for the rest of the year, we could give ourselves koyach to feel more real. Because I'm not going to compare myself to Yom Kippur. This coming year, the tshuva of the Sheshes Yemei Chol, the tshuva of Pam Ken Pam Lo, will be something that I will actually start to believe in. And as much as I tell myself, even a little bit is good, even a little bit is good, how much do I actually believe that? And we're going to go out of the text right now before we see one last thing. All year long, I wish I could say, you know, I know I get a glimpse of myself on Yom Kippur of the real me. And then I'm going to ask myself, am I for real? But this year, we don't even have that so much. But that is because the Ribbono Shel Olam is giving us a chance to not compare ourselves to that moment, that one day of looking like a malach. The answer of Yom Kippur, of feeling the Kedusha of Yom Kippur this year, is am I for real? And answering ourselves, maybe when we're sitting at home, or maybe when we're walking back from shul at 10:30 in the morning, 11 in the morning, or whatnot, the whole experience of feeling this closeness this year is going to give us batteries that we could feel close the whole year. It's going to give us the batteries to embrace the tshuva of Sheshes Yemei Chol. It's going to give us the koyach to believe in the Pam Ken, Pam Lo. Because until Mashiach comes, we're in the world of Sheshet Yemei Chol. When Mashiach comes, Ba Menucha, Ba Shabbos. Remember what happened when Rabbi Nachman was born? I think his uncle, Feter Baruch, Baruch Mejibushir said, they call him Nachman, Zeyen Nachameinu Mima'aseinu. This Rabbi Nachman, like Noach, it says about Noach that he brought the Nechama to the world. Zeyen Nachameinu Mima'aseinu. He will bring us some type of a Nechama, some type of a consolation, some type of a quiet in the heart. However, where it's not enough to just feel like we could fly on Yom Kippur. It's not enough. We have to feel like we can do this every day of the year. We have to feel like we could do this Shabbos afternoon when there's no company. It's just us at home. There's no one else. There's no one else on their way. It's whatever I have in front of me. Sheshet Yemei Chol, to accept the reality of Sheshet Yemei Chol, the tshuva, the moments that I experience a desire to be close, they are real, they last, and they define the real me. Because like the Zohar HaKadosh says, a winner is someone who's on the battlefield with his weapon. One more Shabbos, one more Vort, one more Torah, one more Chesed. Just a little bit more. Am I for real? So let's see how Reb Nosson ends this all off. Reb Nosson takes Reb Nachman's understanding of tshuva, but he gives it to us. See, Reb Nosson gives it to us like sweet honey on a spoon. Reb Nosson says, Nikuti alochos al yedei kol bakasha u bakasha. Va'al yedei kol drisha u drisha shedoresh u mevakesh u mechapes limtso kvod kdushato yitbarach. Through every asking, through every request, through every appeasement, through every demanding, where you demand, you search and you look to find Hashem. Va'al yedei kol tnu'a u tnu'a shepone l'kdusha. Every movement you have towards kdusha. I'll just tell you a very good way to implement this, a very good way to become attuned to this way of every movement that I have to Kedusha. Did you ever look at your feet while you were walking to shul? I mean, probably not because you're scared you're going to bump into a wall or something, but I think it's a wonderful thing. I try to do this, to take a look at your legs while you're walking towards shul, or while you're walking towards the Beis Midrash, or while you're walking to somewhere where there's a chance to experience more godliness in the world, be aware of it. You know what, did we take into account, like when we're looking back at our accounting this year, you know, how many steps did we actually take? I know we were very big on counting our steps when it comes to exercising. What about counting our steps? How many steps did we take this year that took us to shul, or to a shir, or to an act of chesed? Thousands upon thousands upon thousands. Tnuot sheponot el akdusha. Reb Nosson says, Al yidei kol ze zoche bechol pam. Every time, he says, you merit, when you do this, every single request for holiness. Zoche bechol pam leshaper chomot barzel udlatot nechoshet. Every time, just a little bit more, Reb Nosson says, you break down iron walls and doors of copper. Meaning, every single time you take into account, you're taking a walk to shul. I'm going to be very visual right now. I want you all to like look at your finger right now, okay? You don't have to lift it up. Just look at your finger for a second, okay? How many buttons did this finger touch right now in order to spend your Motzei Shabbos trying to get a hit'alut ruchanit? Don't think right now about how many times this finger, or if you're a lefty, this finger, whatever it is, they used buttons to take you away from it. Think right now about how many movements of your finger did you use right now in order to be here right now? Reb Nosson says, take count of that. Look at your finger right now and say, thank you, precious finger. Thank you. Take count of it. Why? Because this little click, I'm not saying this because you're with me, I'm saying because you're it's a pnia el kedusha. This click, this finger, just this finger, has the power and the ability to tear down walls of steel and dlatot nechoshet. I don't know what's going to be after the shir. Like Reb Nosson says, afal pi she'achar kach mitgabrim alav b'chol pam rachmanan litzlan. Even though afterwards the finger is used for something else. Afal pi chen en yegiyo larik chas v'sholom. The times that you use your finger to click into Kedusha, don't think they just larik, went for nothing. Ve'in shum tnu'a she'poneh la'kedusha ne'evedet. This is so important. Maybe this is another, this perhaps could be another beautiful thing to print out and put on our shtenders. Ein shum tnu'a she'ponah la'kedusha ne'evedet. Any movement which was poneh, which was facing, went towards holiness, never goes lost. Never gets lost. You had a moment of wanting dvekut, even though it didn't last, you can't feel it, it doesn't get lost in the world of Hashem. V'im u'chazak ve'amitz levakesh u'lechapes yoter, af im yavor alav ma. And the more strong and courageous you are to keep on asking for more and more, no matter what happened to you, bevadai sof kol sof yiske limtzo to itbarach. At the end, Reb Nosson says, because every time that you use that finger for Kedusha, the feet for Kedusha, the eyes for Kedusha, the heart for Kedusha, the lungs to breathe in Hashem's air and to acknowledge Hashem in the world, that's a pnia la Kedusha. The more that you do that, and eventually, Reb Nosson says, eventually, all those moments will come together and break down any barriers. So let's go back to the title of this shir, the year where our questions get answered. That question that the soul asks is the question that gets answered. Ve'initem et nafshotechem. Like we began. It's not our bodies that get an answer. Ve'initem et nafshotechem ve'anitem. You give an answer to your nefesh, and your nefesh is asking, am I keeping my shlichut ne'emana while I'm down here in this world? The neshama on Yom Kippur has the guts to look up to Hashem and say, am I doing a good job? Are we still intact? That's the question. Am I still doing my shlichut ne'emana? And together with the guf that's in a state of inui, the body and the nefesh answer each other and say yes, because I believe in the tshuva of Shesh Yisimei Achol. I believe in the tshuva of the moments that they never get lost. And I believe that eventually there'll be enough dots that we can connect a full line together. So this year, like we said before, this Yom Kippur, which is going to be a different Yom Kippur than we ever did, it's amazing that you can't rely on necessarily on the ruach of what's going to happen in the shul, because we're not going to be in shul. We'll have a minyan. Hopefully, each person will have a minyan that is good for their neshama. But that sense of, you know, the swimming in it, it's different this year. It's the Ribbono Shel Olam forcing us to look at the Nekudos Tovos and say, you want an answer to the question, am I for real? You know the answer. You get the answer. The fact that we're even having this conversation is proof that the answer is yes, we are for real. And that Be'ezrat Hashem, when we say, V'tetiv lanu achatima, Hashem Yitbarach, make it good for us, that as we're sealed in the book of life, living for you, that we get a sense that every other person that maybe doesn't look like they're for real to us, they're also in it, and they're also meeting themselves, and everyone is doing the best that they possibly can right now in this moment. We're doing the best that we can. And look at your feet when they take you to Kol Nidre tomorrow night, friends. Or, if you're not supposed to go to shul, observe yourself sitting on the couch or sitting where you're supposed to be and realize that is just as holy as going to shul. That's an awareness of I want Kedusha, I'm on the battlefield and the weapon's in my hand. I give us all a bracha to be gebenched. L'chaim toivim tichteveinu tichtemeinu. We should be sealed in the book of knowing good, a life of having good news and of good health and of be'emet, incorporating this tshuva that Rabbi Nachman spoke about tonight. And understanding that what the Rambam told us in the beginning, one mitzvah to here, one mitzvah to there, it doesn't mean, the Rambam saying, it's not going to take a perfect person to tilt the scales. What is it going to take according to the Rambam? One aha moment. Pa'am ken. If pa'am lo can tilt everything the other way, the Rambam's basically saying a pa'am ken moment, a moment of realizing I'm going towards shul, I'm going towards kedusha. One moment. That could change the whole world. And it could take the whole world to Kav Zchut. And we have so many moments from now until Yom Kippur and on Yom Kippur that we can have an aha moment. And since we never know which moment will tilt the scales, let's just make sure we treat every single moment like that. Did I die, 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 I didn't need it. Story to give us a lot of chizuk. It was one late at night, one of my favorite stories, once late at night, the Rebbe Reb Simcha Bunim of Pshischa was sitting with his top three Talmidim of the time, the Rebendel of Kotsk, the Chiddush Yarim, and the Pchonach Hanachol of Alexander. And the night was getting very late, It was getting early in the morning. Reb Simcha Bunim is revealing the mysteries of the Torah, secrets of the Torah. And Reb Mendel of Kotzk and the Chiddush Yarim, they were older, they were understanding deeper. Reb Chanuch Henech of Alexander was younger. Simcha Bunim notices, he says, you know, we got to go daven Marv. We have to daven now. We got to daven before you know, Alessa Shachar, or whenever that time was. So Reb Simcha Bunim retires to his own. He goes to his own, like, chamber. No one can see him. The Chiddush Yarim goes to one corner of the Beis Medrash, and the Kotzke Rebbe goes to another corner of the Beis Medrash. Reb Chanuch Henech of Alexander, he says, I want to see how these top students daven after learning such Torah. So Reb Henech says, he went to go see the Chiddush Yarim. He sees swaying, Reb Ichimai is swaying from side to side, and he's davening fast and gay. They daven fast, screaming, but he's davening side to side, and it's such motion, such hislav, with such enthusiasm. He says, that's not me. I gotta go see how the Kotzke davens. He goes to see Reb Mendel of Kotzk, and basically what he sees is a pillar standing like this, not moving, but he looks down at where the Kotzke is standing and he sees a pool of tears. He says, tears? I never cried before in davening. It's not me either. He goes into his own zone and he says, Ribono Shleinam, I have no idea how to daven. I have no idea how to daven. This is crazy. How could I even talk to you? They reconvene right before Nates. And Reb Simcha Bunim, you know, he was in tune with whatever was going on upstairs, right? So he turns to the Kotzke. He says, Mendele. You know, like reporting back what they said in heaven. Mendele. Wow. Itchemayer. Turns to Chiddush Yarim. Itchemayer. Shekoyach. Ah, Henachal, Henachal, Henachal. Henachal, do you have any idea? Do you have any idea how many screens you tore down in Shemayim with that krechts of yours saying, I don't even know how to daven. How do I even begin to daven? Henachal, what you did in Shemayim, what you did in Shemayim. I think that this, to answer the question, anyone that comes before the Ribono Shleilam with the conviction of I am for real, he misses out on an opportunity to connect to the Ruach of Chonach Henachal of Alexander, of tearing down any machitzas that still may be between our Father in Heaven and his children that are so much desiring to still be close to him. And Baruch Hashem, by now, most of us are willing to admit that we have absolutely no idea. Even with all the tools you gave us, we don't know how to do it on a manual level, but on a heartsig neshama level. No one like us. We do know how to cry. We do know how to admit that we don't know anything. And we do know how to say, I'm sorry we didn't believe in ourselves enough this year. Please forgive us. And Be'ezra Hashem, this Yom Kippur, we're going to hear, Vayomer Hashem Salachti Kidvarecha. I forgive you in accordance to your words that you're going to believe in yourselves more this year. Salachti Kidvarecha. You're going to believe more in the aha moments of tshuva, even though they don't last for too long. Alavai, they should last, but if they don't, Salachti Kidvarecha. You ask tshuva based on that. You're saying, I'm sorry based on that. I'm saying, I forgive you based on that. And maybe, perhaps, that can be the real v'teitiv lanu achatima, that the ceiling will just be sweet and good for all of Am Yisrael and kol ha'olam kulo. We love you all, miss you all. A good gebench diur gmar chatima tova, l'chol beit Yisrael. Be'ava rabba, everyone.